I'll be leading on a message which I titled Knowing the Spirit of Truth and the Spirit of Error. The Spirit of Truth and the Spirit of Error. 1 John chapter 4 verses 1 to 6. Knowing the Spirit of Truth and the Spirit of Error. I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
1 John 4, 1. It says, Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone into the world. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is the spirit of Antichrist, whereof you have heard that it should come. Even now, already, it is in the world. You are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. They are of the world, therefore speak they of the world, and the world hear them. We are of God. He that knoweth God heareth us. He that is not of God heareth not us. Hereby we know the spirit of truth and the spirit of what?
Error.
Hallelujah. Now the title of the message is saying, knowing. The Bible says in the last verse, in verse 6, it says, we are of God. Whoever is of God hears us. When we are praying, when we are speaking, when we are preaching, whoever is of God gives attention. Why? We are discussing the things that belong to the Father.
Yes,
amen. Whoever is not hearing me now, whoever is not listening to me now, whoever is not understanding what I'm saying, is not of God. Amen.
Amen.
We are of God, and whoever is of God heareth us. How do we know the spirit of error? The spirit of error does not confess Jesus came in the flesh. Amen.
Amen.
The spirit of error is where somebody begins to preach himself more than the gospel of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We see many, many Christian denominations today, many churches, where pastors assume the position of God. The pastor teaches more of himself than the gospel of Jesus Christ. They teach more of themselves. They exalt themselves more than the word of God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
This is the spirit of God. The Bible says, be careful, my family. Be careful. Why? There are many false spirits that has gone into the world. Why have they come to the world where we are? They want to deceive people. Why are they going to deceive people? Why? They have lost their glory. They want you to lose your crown of glory. So they are going to do anything possible to deceive you. Amen. Amen. And the Bible says, this is the spirit of Antichrist. When we make the word Antichrist, don't wait to see that big beast.
No.
Don't wait to see that 666 as we were taught when we were coming. The spirit of Antichrist, the word Antichrist is opposite. Amen. So anything contrary to Christ is Antichrist. If I should be walking towards this direction, I am going towards this direction. Let's assume this is Christ. I am going towards direction. I am what?
Antichrist.
Because why? I'm doing opposite. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
He said, beloved, believe not all spirits. It is not everyone who stands to tell you this word that are saying it from the heart. Some are not genuine spirits. There is a video I shared on the church group. Amen. I don't know if many of you have seen it. Amen.
Amen.
That spirit tried to consume that boy. Because he knew there is something in that boy that God loves. He went after him. Many of you, you will prefer to enjoy the pleasure of now than to suffer for now and face the future. But many of you prefer to enjoy the now and suffer in the future. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You may go through darkest time of your life now. It does not mean that God is not seeing you. God uses this thing to train you, to bring you up. Amen. But we prefer to listen to people that will tell us it is well when nothing is well. We prefer to hear men of God that will say, let me prophesy to you. Before you get miracle money, firstly ask, where is this money coming from? What am I going to give in exchange of this money? What should I do with this money? What you don't work for? Listen, many of you believe so. I believe, but I don't believe miracle money. I believe for money I worked for. Amen.
Amen.
If you don't work, you don't get paid. That's what the Bible says. Amen.
Amen.
So many of you may believe it, but the truth is, what in exchange does this money want from you? Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
The Bible says here, it says, try all spirits, whether they are of God. He said, while many spirits have gone into the world, many deceiving spirits have entered, not even in the world, have entered in the church, deceiving people. Every one of you, whenever somebody is talking to you, be very, very inquisitive, be very, very sharp in your spirit to understand where the issue is going. What does this issue tend to bring me? To what purpose is it coming? And how is it going to help me? By the time you are able to understand, before, you should know where you are going. Amen. Before you start engaging, I love this about Genesis chapter 3. When Adam be Eve had understood that the devil came for a mission, she wouldn't have given ear to the devil. But because the issue was so sweet, she was given, okay, let me hear. You said I will be naked, but it doesn't matter if I'm naked, but I will understand. Amen. She gave ear. Many of us, we desire to give our ear to people who tell us sweet things, not telling us what is based on the scripture. The sweet things are good, but the truth is, if God allowed you to be down now, you know why he allowed you to be down. God is not a wicked God. I don't know if somebody's getting me. God who allowed you to go down, when the right time comes, Ecclesiastes 3:11, he said he made all things beautiful in his time. He will lift you up again. When God spoke to Joseph, Joseph, you are going to become the prime minister, you're going to become this, you're going to become that. Did God ever told you that he was going to fall his way? Did God ever told you that his brothers were going to sell him? No. But these are part of the story. Test all spirit, whoever is talking to you, check from which source the spirit is talking. Amen. Many have been deceived. Jesus almost warned us in Matthew 24, in verses 4. He said, be careful that you be not deceived. Deception is going around the world. Deception is what? Going around the world. Why? The devil lost his crown. He does not want anyone to have that crown of glory on that day. He's doing everything possible to make you lose it. People are willing to buy the lie of the devil as to technology than to obey the voice of God today. Many of you, some of you have been talked out of the ministry. What is making you to stand now is the grace. And the moment you fall out, the devil will have you the way he planned it. You are only standing because the grace is still speaking for you. The moment the grace is cut off from you, you become a victim. So be careful who is talking to you, even in the church. The devil has entered the church. You may find it difficult, but the Bible says in Job chapter 1, it says, when the children of God gather, even the devil gather. The devil was there in the midst. And God asked him, devil, where are you going? Where are you coming from? Say, Father, I just did jiggle up and down. I did 4-1-1 come up for the rain because I don't lose my crown. So I want somebody to lose that crown. No one is getting that crown. As long as I lost mine, they are going to lose here. I will do everything to make sure they fail. The devil is doing everything. Take your Bible. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 3. I'm going to teach on the spirit of error and the spirit of people. Let me go first. 2 Thessalonians 2, 3.
I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let no man deceive you,
mm-hmm,
by enemies, for that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first.
You see that? Amen. Let no man deceive you what? By any means. That is to say, there are means that the devil is going to use to bring you out of this race. As long as you are persistent, as long as you are stubborn to him and said, God alone I will serve, I will not look back, I am choosing to my course, I will not go back, no more to the world, the devil will do everything. It will come with wrong wives, it will come with wrong friends, it will come with wrong people, it will orchestrate people around you to make sure that you fall. It will do everything. Amen.
Amen.
He said, let no man deceive you by what?
Enemies.
He said, unless they be falling away, the devil is going to use everything to make sure you not look like the son of perdition. Don't serve God like weather. Serve God, yaga, yaga. Don't serve God based on what you want. Serve God because it is the duty of a man to serve God. Otherwise, many of you whose love you think you really love God, your love is based on what you get. Many of you, when God gives you your 5 years now, it is only few. Only few that will still remain and say, God, I will serve you to the end.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Don't serve God for what you're going to get. Otherwise, you're going to be deceived. Look, when the devil came to Jesus, he said, listen, not only me are you there here, no person to see us now. This word God give me the moment he cast me down from heaven. So now me get this word. Even as you come now, you're there on my property. I will give you the word. Since nobody can see us now, I will give you everything. Just only bow to me. I will give you the word and everything you ever thought of. And if Jesus was tempted with material things, only if you can stand it.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
I don't know if I'm talking to somebody.
Yes, sir.
Only if you can stand the desire for material things. Jesus said, listen, thou shalt not serve any graven image. Only the Lord thy God. Thou shalt not bow before any other thing. Only God. Means, you know, this is very, very technical. Many of us, the man of God is not here. Neither the church member. Oh, we know I did it. Is this just to bow? Is that what you are saying? Yeah, let me do it and get my destiny. Amen.
Amen.
We set our soul for just property that a day will come, we will leave them behind and face the real life. The real life is not the life here. The real life is the life after here. The continuity of life is not the life you have now, but the life after death. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, what will it profit you, my brothers and sisters, God's kingdom's family, to gain this whole world and lose your soul? That on that day you will say, Lord, if I had known, I wouldn't have. If I had known. The moment you are gone of this earth, there is no repentance. The gate of repentance. Let's take the rich man and Lazarus, for example. The man said, he begged Jesus, he begged Father Abraham, please let me just go back and warn my brothers that where I am now is not good. He said, if they don't listen to the prophets, they will not listen either to you. So just leave your brother issues. Let them make their decisions on earth. So everyone on earth here is making decisions. Be very careful that the devil do not deceive you. Matthew 24 verse 4. Be very careful. Jesus warned. He's a warning. Jesus warned. He said, be careful that no man deceive you. Because there are going to be problems, situations, ugly situations going to come. But be very rooted on your feet that no man remove you.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
It has not come to the place. It's only few people have heard that they have been inserted the IROF ED sheep to buy, let's call it the mark of the beast sheep, to buy things. That their account is controlled, their security, whatever, is in their body. Only few. Amen. The world is moving faster to fulfill the book of Revelation about the Antichrist. Amen. Now the world is fast advancing. But the truth is, if it happens now, Will you still hold your faith and said, I better die than to accept this now? Amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, do not be deceived. Deception is going on everywhere. The spirit of error is a spirit that when it comes in, you don't have value for the life of others.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You don't think of others anymore. When we explain it, we will see from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 16, in one of the verses downward, that the Bible says, the Spirit of the Lord left Saul, when David was as ordained or anointed, the Spirit of God left Saul. And Saul from that moment began to seek the life of David. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, an evil spirit from the Lord. I will correct that place, not evil spirit from the Lord, but an evil spirit entered in him. Why? The God who myself does not give evil spirit. Rather, when you sin against him, he takes his hand away from you. And whatever that will happen to you will happen. Why? God is afraid of sin. He cannot behold sin. He's too righteous to dwell in sin.
Yes,
amen.
Amen.
I do want to make an example now. Far be it that I will be God. I'm holding this thing, protecting it. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Everything I do, my plan is to save it so that it will not be destroyed. But for the fact that this one has coronavirus, which is sin, I will have to let go.
Yes.
And when I let go, my protection is cut off. And whatever will happen to him will happen to him. Is it true?
Yes, sir.
Because why? I'm no longer protecting him. So we don't say the evil spirit from God. The evil spirit that has been hovering all over the earth caught Saul, not from God. Hallelujah. So the spirit of error entered Saul, and Saul began to seek the life of David. Amen. So when the spirit of error is at work, anyone can just let go for just little thing. You can even have sex for two arrows. You can do it sharply as long as no one is there. Amen.
Amen.
You can even want to satisfy your desire. Because why? That's the spirit of error. Read that place again. In verse 3.
Let no man deceive you by any means.
Mm-hmm.
For that day shall not come.
The judgment day will not come. Until what?
Except there come a falling angel.
Until you fall, the judgment day will not come. You that is still standing to the hand, will you stand and say, it will not happen to me? Every day, many are falling. Many are falling. The devil is using tricks to remove them from the kingdom. People who made up their mind said, I will not look back, no matter what. But because of the tricks of the devil, they are gradually falling. Read on.
Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except there comes a falling away first.
And that hidden man that has been telling you to satisfy your desire inside, it will be revealed.
The son of perdition.
Let him that letteth be let. The moment you allow the sinful man to take over your nature, the devil inside you will speak, and therefore you will fall in from grace. Amen. And therefore you have what? Be deceived. That's the spirit of error. Hallelujah. Many of you are still striving hard. You are still keeping your faith because you love God. But the devil, mind you, the devil is fighting after the crown you are longing for. He's fighting you for it. He's fighting you because you choose to serve God. You choose to do what he hates. And therefore, he's attacking your life. But never allow yourself go. Don't allow, don't buy his lie. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
It's lying to you. Then when you go into prostitution, you are going to make it a lie. You don't have to be a prostitute before you make it a lie. You only need to wait for God. When it's God's time, it must only speak. If God has said it, that you will make it a lie. Amen. Little things you will do, it will catapult you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You don't need to sell anything you have. You don't need even to sell drugs. People run into drugs business, into selling of marijuana. These things are the tricks of the devil. Consider the pains you are inflicting on people. Consider what you are doing to people. Amen.
Amen.
Don't buy the trick of the devil that if you don't do this, you don't make it. You are going to make it in life.
Amen.
If God, by divine purpose, brought you here, he didn't bring you here by mistake.
That's all.
He brought you here on purpose.
Yes, sir.
Don't allow him to remove his hand from your life because of your mistake. But rather, be close to him. You see the way that thing fell from my hand? Because I withdrew my hand. You see it? So if God withdraw his protection, you are going to fall. No matter how far, how strong, how mighty you think you are, it will not take the devil one day to remove you down. Amen. Families, please. Let us be very, very careful of how we live our life. Knowing so well that on that day, before God and you alone, you will be standing. Therefore, no one to intercede for you anymore. Not even your father, not even your pastor, not even anyone. You will be left alone. Then before your very eyes, the screen will be open to you. Those things you've done in the secret place, in the hidden place. Those things you refuse to confess that they are sins. Maybe in one way or the other, you did it. You never thought it was a sin. Those things will be played before you. And therefore, the grace has been cut off. The message of Jesus is shut out. Just like the rich man in hellfire, say, just dip a dip of water. Amen.
Amen.
Be very, very careful so that we do not be deceived. The devil is doing everything. I love it when he said the book of Job chapter 1. When God asked him, devil, where are you going? He said, I am going up and down the earth. I am going up and down the earth. I'm looking for someone who has just opened the door so that I can enter to kill, steal, or destroy. I'm looking for that one sister who is not serious with his life, with her life. I'm looking for that brother that is wasting his time. I'm looking for that one person. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
Please, let's continue. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits. You see the word in my Bible here, I underline it. It didn't say try the spirits. Try the spirits. Because why? There are many. This spirit is not one. There are many. They have gone into the world to deceive the elect, to deceive the kingdom people, to deceive the people who Jesus purchased with the blood. He's doing everything to make sure you fall out. He has assigned wrong people to you to make sure one day you listen to them and you will become like them. But every Christian will strive for the faith. I will not give up. Amen.
Amen.
This is the battle we are in. You will strive every day. As long as I live till Jesus comes, I will not give up my faith.
Amen.
This is the battle we must fight. But people prefer to just let go because of riches of the world. If Jesus had allowed the devil to abort the lie of the devil by bowing to him and gaining the whole world, the death would have been in vain. The name we are using today would not have been disinfecting. Amen. This name would not have been disinfecting. But he overcame the lies and the tricks of the devil. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's take our Bible quickly. Okay. John chapter 15. Let's know what is the spirit of truth.
John chapter 15.
Verses 26.
I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceeds from the Father, he shall testify of me.
Now, who is the Spirit of truth? The Comforter. Who is the Comforter? The Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit is at work in you, it is hard for you to be deceived. Somebody following me?
Yes, sir.
You hear him speaking to your heart. You hear him speaking to your ears. You hear him directing you from the inside. What you are about to do, you are about to make a mistake. It will be like a voice to you. That is why every one of us, whenever we want to make a mistake, he always warns us before time. But we desire to go for what we want because of our desire. Amen.
Amen.
So the spirit of truth is the spirit, is the Holy Spirit, the Comforter. He teaches us what the Father wants. He does not speak of himself. He speaks of God. Amen.
Amen.
Please, whenever we're in the church, kindly do me a favor by putting away those phones and put it off. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
He said, but when the Comforter is come, whom I will send. sent unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceeds from the Father, he shall what? Testify. You remember the first John where we read, he said, every spirit that does not confess Jesus, he said, is the Antichrist. Then every spirit that confesses Jesus Christ is Lord and came in the flesh is what? The Spirit of God. And the Bible says, no man by the Spirit of God collect Jesus across. If the Holy Spirit is at work in you, you will always worship. You will always love to worship God. But when the spirit of error is at you, every little thing you find error, even in the church. Amen.
Amen.
No matter how good the message of the man of God, you find error. No matter how the worship goes, no matter whatever that is happening, you still find error. Why? The devil is after you. He's wanting to kick you out. So first, it causes you to hate God, to hate people around you, and to see error. And the moment you start seeing error, pray. 2 Thessalonians 2:3. He said, "What until there be what falling away first, that day will not come." So you are about to fall. That is why the devil has entered to destroy. Praise the living God. 2 Peter 2:2.
I read in Jesus' name.
Just read from verse 1.
Okay. Verse 1. But there be also false prophets among the people.
Mm-hmm.
Even as there shall be false teachers among you.
Mm-hmm.
Damnable heresies.
Mm-hmm.
Even denying the Lord that brought them and bring upon themselves.
Denying the Lord Jesus that brought them. Uh-huh.
And bring upon themselves sweet.
Fast destruction. This is what is going on. Human desire, they prefer to destroy themselves than obey one who has brought them. Verse 2.
And many shall follow their
pernicious ways.
By reason of whom the way of
you see, many shall follow that dangerous way by the reason of truth. Now, the one who speaks truth, the devil has now turned him to become a liar, and people prefer to buy the lie than to buy truth. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Many people have been deceived day by day when they say your pastor is this. They don't care to go in and look whether what they say is true. But they buy the lie of the devil. Be careful. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
That sister is a witch. That brother is a wizard. Look who is telling you this. To what purpose? What does he want from you? Before you start judging somebody to me, what do you want from me? What are you after?
Mm-hmm.
By the time you understand the one talking to you, you will understand the one that they are speaking of. Amen.
Amen.
If I come to you and say, this brother A is evil, I should be after something for telling you. If not because I have issue with brother A, then I am yet to bring you down against brother A. I don't know if you get it now.
Yes,
if I say brother A, if I say this pastor is not good to the church, it's either I have problem with him or I want to destroy you against him. So be careful when somebody comes to you. This thing is not good. This pastor, this. Please examine who is talking to you first. Before you even watch the people they are referring to. The Bible says, test all spirits whether they are of God. Test even the person talking to you, whether he's talking from God or not. Why? 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 14. The devil has sworn to become what? The angel of light.
2 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 14. I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And no matter, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light.
Church, do not marvel. Why? Even the devil, whom we used to expect is a black wicked two-horned, red two-horned, with big nose, with that big fork to chew. No! He's no longer what he used to be. He has not turned into an angel of light. Oh, peace, peace. We have said peace from their mouth in their heart. Destruction is there. Be careful who is talking to you. Why? The devil is no longer what you used to expect. He's no longer that serpent. He's not that wicked brother in that sister.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Jam your hands for Jesus. Be careful. Because the Bible says, do not marvel. For Satan, he said, is transformed into what? An angel. If the devil can transform to become an angel of light, then be very careful. Every day, everything people tell you, measure it with the word of God so that you don't fall. While they are after you, they have lost it. They can come like a pastor, whereas they are not pastors. They can come like Christian sisters and brothers, whereas they are not. They are after what you have. Because where you are going, they see that you are heading for the crown. They can do everything to make you lose it because they have lost theirs. Amen.
Amen.
If this crown is not valuable, if it's not so much important, why is the devil still fighting over it? Why is the devil still fighting believers who are heading for that crown? Today, people repent, confess their sins, give up their old life, and face the work. But not long, the devil will deceive them. Amen.
Amen.
Many fall by day by day. But you who is standing, you are standing by grace.
Amen.
I pray that grace will not be departed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say, I pray that grace will not depart from your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In verses 15. It's not a big deal. Please, on Tuesday, it will be the continuation of this message. On Tuesday, as you come, God Almighty will bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's go on our feet. I just want to be where you are, dwelling daily in your presence. Take me to the place where you are. I just want to be with you. I just want to be with you forever. Pray this prayer. How many of you are willing to change and give back your life to God? Lift up your hands. If you want to return to Him, if you acknowledge you have made mistake, you want to come back to Him. That the life you are living is not the right life. Lift up your hands. What about if the trumpet sounds now? Those of you whose hands are down, are you sure you're going to make the kingdom? Those of you who think that you are already in the kingdom, even now, if something would happen, are you sure you are making the kingdom? This is your time of salvation. is a time of deliverance. I want to see those hands boldly up. If you want to make, you want to reaffirm your covenant with Him, say after me in a loud voice, say, Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
in a loud voice from your heart, say, Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
I come to you
just as I am,
and yours I am. I am a sinner.
I
acknowledge myself as a sinner, and I cannot help myself. Help me, Lord. Change me, Lord. I know you paid it for me. I know you paid it all for me. I know you purchased it. From today, I'm no longer a debtor. I'm no longer a sinner. By the finished work of the cross, I acknowledge myself as a son of the kingdom of God, as a joint heir with you. From today, Lord, be my Lord and personal Savior. I will not go back to sin. I will not go back to that life. Write my name in the book of life so that after a year, I will find it with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Please, if you have prayed that prayer, I want you to commune with your heart. Say, Lord, from this moment, I am yours. Just in 50 seconds, say, Lord, I will not go back. Whatever sins you need to confess, confess them. I'm here to prophesy upon your life. I am a son of God. I'm a daughter of God. I am free today. I'm no longer a debtor. I'm no longer dwelling in sin. Something has happened in my life. I am a new man in Christ. I am a new man in Christ. My life has taken a new round, a new turn from this moment. I will no longer live as a sinner. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we thank you for everyone here. And we thank you for your word.